Hey guys, welcome in. We'll go ahead and get started. No, isn't it from life? So, guys, tonight we're having Hawaiian sticky chicken with pineapple. So I'm going to go ahead and get my hands washed up and we're going to get ready to go. It should be relatively easy. We've only got a few steps. It's going to be really smelling good in the kitchen tonight and it's going to taste wonderful. So we're going to go ahead and get dried off. So tonight, as I walk you down through here, I'll show you. We've got our pepper. We've got our onion. We've got our cornstarch already measured out, which is 1 tablespoon. We've got a pinch of salt and pepper. I've got my chicken breast, which we'll be cutting up here in just a second. I've got my pineapple chunks, which is in the juice, which we'll be reserving the juice, which we'll do that here in a few minutes. I've got 3 tablespoons of soy sauce. I've got 1 tablespoon of tomato paste, and I have 2 tablespoons of brown sugar. So I have some coriander, which we'll be able to bring out here in a few minutes, and the sriracha, which we'll also use there to finish it off. And that is just if you guys are interested in it. You don't have to. It's just if you want to at the end. So like I said, we'll deal with that in a few minutes. So first things first, so we don't have to switch out our cutting board, let's go ahead and get our vegetables cut up. And then after we cut up the vegetables, then we can move over to the chicken and we don't have to worry about going back and forth with the cutting boards. So we'll go ahead and take care of our bell pepper first because that way the onion flavor won't be too harsh with it. If we were doing something such as a salad that some people don't want the onion, you just have to watch and be mindful of the flavors on the cutting board. So our bell pepper. Notice we have the 3 bumps, which is a male. If you guys remember back to when we was doing our Come Cook with Joe and the scallops, we used a bell pepper. But the ones with the 3 bumps are the male. And that's better for cooking because they hold up. They're a little bit more tough. If you have a bell pepper with 4 bumps on the bottom, that's the female. And they're more tender and soft. And so those are better if you want it on a salad or for dipping in ranch sauce. So we'll go ahead and get started. So I'm just going to go ahead and take the stem off. So we've got a flat work surface. So we're going to take our knife and we're going to come in at the top point and go down and around just like we're peeling an apple. And now we've got all of our seeds left, and we don't have any seeds in our flesh here, which is going to be good for us, so we don't have to worry about those. So we'll go ahead and take that and throw it in the trash. All right, now we'll just come back in here, and we'll start making our cuts for slices, and then we'll turn to the side, and then we'll come back, and we'll dice that pepper out. So I hope everyone's had a good week so far. It's been sort of fun for me. I've been back at work, like I told you guys last week, and we haven't got our students back yet, so we're still working on educational packets and other things along those lines. So hopefully we can get back to normal, some sort of normalcy, I guess, which would be nice. So, plus we aren't able to utilize our Lebanon Caliente Cafe yet, which is something we do for the staff and our students every other week on Fridays. So we'll usually do a sandwich and a salad and a dessert for $5. Okay. So now we've got our pepper cut up, and what we're going to do with that is we're going to go ahead and take that and put it here on a paper plate just to get it out of our way. And now we'll come back in here with our onion. So we'll go ahead and start getting it peeled off a little bit. Get the trash taken care of. So originally with this recipe, it calls for these just to be cut into cubes. Quarter it. I think I'm going to dice it, though. Different ways you can experiment with this recipe. You can dice out your onion. You can quarter it. You can You can cut them into slices and then wring them out. So it just all depends on what you want to do. So I'm just going to come in here and I'm going to make these cuts going down and then come in and make these cuts and then dice your onion out. So, I was sort of debating about next week. So I'll go ahead and say this while I'm doing this, so you guys will know. Next week's going to be sort of a special event. I have a prior engagement on Friday, and so I have to prep for that on Thursday. So what I'm going to do, I think, is I'm going to tape the gumbo on Saturday, this coming Saturday, and then I will upload it to our Facebook and our YouTube channel on Thursday. So that way you guys will get the whole caboodle about cooking Louisiana gumbo from scratch. So I will be putting that recipe on the Facebook. And hopefully you guys can take your time on Thursday and really make a great meal for your family. That one's really fun, and I really enjoy cooking gumbo.
Your mom said a friend you can work with said that you have the dining room to work with
in
like a five-star restaurant.
Well, that's awesome. I'm glad they think that. We really take pride in what we do there, though, so that's a good thing for us. So, okay, so now we've got all of our onions and pepper diced up. So now I'm going to go ahead and grab our chicken breast and bring them over here. So with the chicken breast, what we're going to do, since we're going to be putting the cornstarch and the salt and pepper on there, we're going to go ahead and dice this up and throw it right into the bowl that we're going to do that with. Okay, so I'm going to come in here, and this one's got a pretty decent side of fat on it. So I'm just going to take that right off with my knife. Easily done. And then this, guys, is just real easy. You're just going to be making your cuts lengthwise. There we go, right? And then I'm just going to come in here and dice this chicken up. So make it in decent-sized chunks. You don't have to make it in real, real small pieces. So I'm just going to chunk it up. Put that right in there, I think. So the gumbo has quite a different to it. It's you've got chicken. I put shrimp. I use usually a whitefish. And chicken, shrimp, whitefish, and andouille sausage. So, and it, like I said, it's a fun time. So really going to have a fun one with that one, I think. It's time consuming. So the roux, like I told you guys before, takes 45 minutes from start to finish, and you can't leave the stove whenever it's cooking, because if you stop stirring, it's going to burn on you. So you have to make sure you got 45 minutes dedicated to standing over your stove while that cooks. But the payoff is very, very good. So you guys would really like that roux once it gets done. Kim's asking who wants to come over Saturday for dinner, because we'll probably have a lot left over. We usually do. I usually take some to work, and we eat it that night, and it makes quite a bit. So, but it, like I said, it's a good time. And a lot of people are scared of getting into gumbo because they're just scared of the roux. A couple different ways you can actually do the roux is on the stovetop, like what I'm talking to you about. So it's just 1 cup oil and 1 cup flour. You can do it that way, or you can actually do it in the oven. So you just get a baking sheet and put your flour on the baking sheet without any oil, just the flour itself. Cook it at 450 degrees for an hour, and by that time it should cook off. So a couple different ways to do it. We will actually be doing it with the oil, though. Give my hands a good quick wash. Dealing with chicken juices is not a good thing in the kitchen unless you wash your hands and clean the surfaces.
So Brandy Hopkins said that she has never had gumbo, but I think I'm going to try it.
Oh, awesome. Brandy, I think you'll really like it. Through school, me teaching the class, it's something that the guys always wanted to know how to do, and it's something that I learned pretty early in the cooking stages, and just really fell in love with it. I've always been a sucker for gumbo anyways, unless I go to Alabama. Sorry, Alabama, but you guys don't have good gumbo down there. They don't have gumbo should have a kick. So down there, they don't have much of a kick, and I was sort of disappointed. Being down there on the ocean, I thought we'd have some pretty good gumbo. So, but anyways, story for another time. So I've got my chicken here. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and take our 1 tablespoon of cornstarch, which I've already measured out. If you haven't got it measured out, it's fine. Just grab you a teaspoon or a tablespoon and just measure that out and throw it in there. So I just had it on a paper towel so we could have it. And then we're going to take a pinch of salt and we will take a pinch of pepper. Just like that. And then we're going to get in here and stir this up. Make sure that the chicken is well coated. And what that's going to do is basically once it gets in that pot, it's going to caramelize and thicken around the chicken and give it a good, nice crust. Because we're going to be putting some oil in our pan here in a minute. Okay. Now, there we go. We've got the chicken in. So now what we'll do is I'm going to go ahead and wash my hands again. And I think what we'll do next is we'll go ahead and get our sauce made up. That way, whenever we're ready to start cooking, we'll just cook all the way through. So I'll go ahead and get my oil in my pan next, just so I can get it started to get hot. Because that's one thing that we want to make sure that the oil is nice and hot. Now, don't get it to the flash point, because then you're going to have a kitchen fire. And that's not going to be very fun. So this usually calls for 3 tablespoons of oil, so I'm just going to pretty much guesstimate that. So we'll go right there. And I'm going to turn this on to about a medium to medium-high heat. Again, just keep your eye on it. I don't want it to get too hot for you guys, because if it does get to that point, then what you need to do is grab you some of your cornstarch and throw it on there, and it, or some flour, either one. And it'll put it out here. Don't ever throw water on a grease fire. So remember, if it's wood, then it's good for the blue stuff to go on the red stuff to put it out. But if it's a grease fire, you don't want to do that. So I'm going to take our chicken and set it over here right next to our pan. So whenever we're ready for it, we're good to go. So the next thing, we have our bowl. And I have my pineapple juice. I'm going to bring all these ingredients down to the corner of the table here, or the bar. Okay, now, guys, you're going to need a paper plate with a paper towel, because what we're going to do is we're going to drain the juices off into the bowl, because that's what we're going to mix all that into. The pineapple is going to go on the plate. We're going to dry that off with the towel. So if you've got a paper towel handy, go ahead and grab that. And so I'm going to grab a nice sieve here, a colander, and throw it in here. Get my handy dandy pineapple can open. Be careful with the lid because they are very sharp. I'm just going to pour that right in there. Now again, we're retaining the juices because that's going to be the major part of the base of the sauce. So once we throw that on. So I'm just going to basically take that. Now I'm going to take the pineapple and put it right here on the paper towel. So, and then this can go into the dirty sink. Now I've got my juice. So that's ready to be set up. I'm going to grab another couple paper towels just so we can blot the top of our pineapple and make sure that those are dried real good. Where am I at? Up or down, huh?
That's what I'm seeing.
Okay, well, I got it up a little bit, so. Okay. So now we've dried our pineapple, so that's good. It's going to sit right there for a little bit. And then what we're going to do next is we're going to go ahead and get this sauce incorporated. So again, 3 tablespoons of soy sauce. We're going to pour that right in. We've got 1 tablespoon of tomato paste. So we're going to get that in there. And again, if you haven't pre-measured, it's fine. Don't freak out. Just go ahead and grab your measuring cups and spoons and do what you got to do. So I'm going to leave that there for a second. And then I have 2 tablespoons of brown sugar. Now, soft brown sugar. I'm assuming what they mean by that is light brown sugar, because you've got a light brown sugar and a dark brown sugar. So I'm sure they're probably talking about a light. I went ahead and packed those in, though, so I've got that in there now. So I'm just going to go ahead and take this spoon that I used for the tomato paste and pretty much just get everything incorporated. Here in a minute, I might go grab the whisk in order to make sure I've got everything in there together. Good. Okay, let me grab this small whisk. All right. Want to make sure you give that a really, really good stir, because that brown sugar, you want to make sure that you're breaking that up and it doesn't stay clumped together or sunk at the bottom. So we want to make sure that that's getting incorporated into the liquids. The tomato paste is already broken up for me, so that's a good thing. Like I said, I just want to make sure that those sugar crystals start to break down while they're in the liquid here. So, all right, now that's ready. So now what we can do is come back over here with our oil. So you see the oil is good and runny now. It's a little bit warmer. So I'm going to go ahead and take the chicken and throw it right on top of the oil. Grab my spatula and make sure that that all gets apart so it can start getting golden brown and cook through. In fact, I think I got a little bit too much oil in here, so I'm going to go ahead and take this. I am just going to drain a little bit of that oil off. All right. Basically, what I don't want to do there is, because the chicken's going to put out a little bit of water, and whenever I go back to reduce this sauce, because I want it to be sticky and nice and thick, I don't want that to incorporate and cause problems. So now we're sitting pretty. So I'm going to go ahead and wash my hands, because again, I touched the chicken. So I'm thinking tonight sometime or tomorrow, I'll probably go ahead and get the ingredients and everything that you're going to need for the gumbo up online. And that way you guys will have plenty of time to get a hold of it. And then, like I said, I'm going to do it Saturday, but then I will upload it on Thursday. So that way you guys won't miss a week with us. So make sure that you're moving your chicken around. Make sure that you're getting browned on all sides. So that'll just take a few minutes to cook. So after this, what we're going to do is we're going to add the onions and peppers. So I'm going to go ahead and grab those and bring them over to my countertop here. Now, the one thing I need to tell you guys is that it calls for ginger. I'm going to use ginger paste. If you went out and purchased ginger root, you can go ahead while your chicken's cooking and get that cleaned up. Remember I said you grab you a spoon, a good hard spoon. And then just take that and scrape off the skin of your ginger. And then basically what you have to do is just one or two things. You can either put it into a quick food processor, or you can go ahead and grab your grater and just grade that up. So, but with that ginger paste, it's a little bit easier sometimes just to grab that. And your ginger can last longer in the refrigerator if you have that paste. Now, we see on the chicken that the salt and pepper stuck to the chicken pretty good, and that's basically because the cornstarch was on there. So that's another good thing that we want to see with that. So we want some good flavoring on the chicken.
Jeff Silver just said the plumber and he died when you poured oil down the drain.
Kim was just telling me that Jeff Tilford was making a comment about pouring the oil down the drain. I at least I know who to call whenever I have problems with my plumbing over here. All right, guys. We don't really have to worry about this too much cooking all the way through at this point in time because it's still got a long way to go. And so what I'm going to do is I just want to make sure that the outside gets browned and good and tan like what we're seeing here. All right. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to add the onions and peppers to this because this is golden on all sides. So I'm going to go ahead and add the onion and pepper. That way these can start cooking down. The onion can start becoming translucent and the peppers can start breaking down. Again, it's going to add some liquid to that again. but it also is going to start marrying all the different flavors together. So if you see a big piece of chicken that you think is just a little bit too big, you can go ahead and take your spatula and just cut it up. So I've got a couple like that. But again, we're going to be serving this over rice. So it's fine if they're in a little bit bigger pieces. So that's taken care of. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to add into the mix. We're going to go ahead and throw our pineapple on. So I'm going to come back over to our bar and I'm going to grab our pineapple that we have sitting here on the countertop, dry it off and ready to roll. After your onions and peppers have cooked for about a minute, minute and a half, 2 minutes, then we're going to go ahead and add this pineapple in on top of it. The chicken's already starting to smell good with the peppers and onions. Go ahead and throw the pineapple on top of there and get it starting to cook, getting those juices out of the pineapple and marrying the flavors with everything that we've got in the pot so far. All right, we're going to let that cook for a couple more minutes, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and grab the garlic and the ginger. So the garlic and the ginger is both in the refrigerator, so I'm going to grab those while that's cooking. So I've got my ginger paste here and my garlic minced over here on the side. If you have cloves of garlic, hopefully you've already went ahead and minced those up. I've been a bad cook tonight, and I should have told you guys this in advance. Calls for 2 cloves of garlic, so I'm just going to take a tablespoon worth and plop it right in there, because a tablespoon of minced garlic is about worth 1 clove of minced. And then this should be a 1x1 cube, so what I'm going to do is just pretty much eyeball it. So ginger, I love the flavor of ginger, so that's why I don't mind a little bit extra in there. So then we're going to go ahead and get all that incorporated. Now, again, with your oils and your garlic that's in there, I want to make sure that you guys don't burn your garlic. So just with the juices, you shouldn't. You shouldn't have to worry about that. If we was doing a dry minced garlic, that would be more of a problem, because then you'd have a greater chance of that burning. But with all the liquid that's in the bottom and that pineapple, you can see it starting to thicken up, which is really cool. All right, now what we need to do is we need to get our sauce in here. So come back over to the table or a bar and grab our sauce. I'll give it one more good stir, just make sure that brown sugar's off the bottom. And then we're going to take that and we're going to add it in right over top of that. Oops. Ah. I saved it. All right, get everything in there mixed up good. Now what we're going to do is the fun part. So now we want to make sure that that gets up really high. So I've turned it almost all the way to high. And I'm going to allow the sauce to get bubbly and boil and to thicken for me. And again, just like the other day whenever we was making, the Tuscan chicken. The longer you let that sit and boil, the thicker the sauce is going to become. So right now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and cook this off for about 5 or 6 minutes on high heat, like I said, to reduce it down and to make it thicker. And it's also going to really establish those flavors. So what you can do right now, if you haven't cooked it off yet, go ahead and grab your rice. If you're going to serve this over rice, you can do it with rice or noodles. But go ahead and get your rice cooked off just per the instructions on the bag. So most of the time it's a couple cups of water to a cup of rice, and get that boiling, and then of course then you can return that off and let it sit, and as that sits it's going to absorb the water, and then you're going to have some decent rice. Now we are cheating because Kim doesn't care much for rice in itself, so we are using cauliflower rice, and we are using, is it bird's eye? Bird's eye cauliflower rice. So that's what we have done. So next week, whenever we do the gumbo, one of two things you can do. You can either go ahead and get you rice that you like. You can try the cauliflower rice, which is in a microwavable bag, and just takes about 4 minutes to get done, which is kind of cool. or you can buy Uncle Ben's minute rice. Is it Uncle Ben's? Am I allowed to say that anymore?
I don't know.
Well, so this is already starting to thicken for us and reduce down a little bit. What? Oh, Kim's laughing at my hands. So I was trying to do a poll this week since I got the page set up. And if you haven't liked my page, come over and like my page. We put other things on there other than just Come Cook with Joe. Matter of fact, I forgot to go to my page in order to start the live feed tonight, but I don't know if everybody's liked it. So here's the situation. With that, I was trying to see how to create a poll to see if you guys like it this way better or like it with Kim filming me better. So I'm still in the, if anyone knows how to do that, just let me know. And then that way I can get a poll set up for you guys and you can let me know which way. Or just drop your answer right here in the comment section. That way if I can know if you guys want to continue doing it this way or if you want to go back to the old format where Kim's filming me actually cook. So I've heard a couple different responses that this way might be a little bit better because you guys can hear me better. I know that not everyone can't see my cute smile, which is what my mother-in-law had said the other day. But I just, I didn't know if this perspective was better for you guys to see. I had a comment said that if there's something technically going on, it's easier to see that way. So just give me your feedback on what you think we should do. It, well, like I said, either stay here or go back to the old format where Kim's filming me cook. Good. I've also been told that I talk a lot more this way. Maybe that I don't have to worry about what I look like talking on the camera. So I don't have to think about what I'm saying, though. I can just do it as I go. So I did have a coworker from work sort of get upset because I was doing too many fish dishes. And so I told her about the YouTube post. So hopefully she can go over there and find some different things. And then this one's chicken tonight, but then, of course, the gumbo is going to have quite a bit of fish in it. So sort of hit and miss. I've been trying to think of some desserts. I was thinking of maybe doing my cherry bombs, which a lot of people really like. That's real easy. So I was thinking about maybe doing that with you guys. It's a party favorite. Everyone loves the cherry bombs because they're just so easy and fun, and they're good. So that might be an option that you guys might want to see. Of course, we did the Buckeye brownies, but I could always come back and show you guys Buckeyes. I was trying to stay away from things that took too long, such as baking. Unless I did like a TV thing and like had one done and one prepared, and so that way you guys can see the finished product. But then now I've got a whole bunch of treats sitting at the house that I don't need. All right. So there is that bird's eye rice cauliflower that we use. I'm going to go ahead and grab our two plates for tonight. Yes, I'm going to go ahead and put this on a plate. And that way you guys can see the different layers to this. Sauce is doing pretty good. It's thickening. As you can see, I can draw my line across and you can see the bottom of the pan, which is a good sign. If not, if it's not thickening up for you fast enough, what you could do is add a little bit more cornstarch. I know we had the cornstarch on the chicken, which is what actually is thickening this up as well, but so is the sugars and all that kind of stuff. But if you do add cornstarch, what I would suggest is adding it to a little bit of water and then mixing it up really good before you add it in. And then be very careful because it's going to thicken up on you real fast. So reducing it this way obviously is going to be a little bit more safer. I know it's a little bit more time consuming, but it's a little bit more safer that it doesn't get too thick too fast on you. And again, the longer you cook this, the thicker it's going to get because you're taking the moisture out of it by evaporation, and that's what's causing your sauce to thicken up. I'm going to let that go for a minute. I'm going to go ahead and get this rice plated. Good. Let's do it this way. All right, I'm just going to take a ladle. I'm just going to come in here and just sort of mash down in the middle. Sort of make a well. Same thing here. Oh, yeah. Smells amazing. Those pineapple chunks are really caramelized now. We've got that red pepper in there with the onions that's been cooking ever since we got it started almost, which is going to be nice and translucent and tender. And I think we're ready to plate this. I'm going to go ahead and turn it off. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to grab the spatula again. I'm going to grab the ladle. I'm going to come in here and just take a good heaping of this and lay it right there in the middle. Looks amazing. Set that off the fire. All right. Now, next thing you could do, if you wanted to, and if you have it, have some coriander. You can go ahead and take that. Do you want some on yours? And just sprinkle it over top. And then we're going to come in, and if you like a little bit of heat, grab you some rasha and take it and just drizzle over top. Now, this can be anyone's personal opinion and how much they want on their dish. Well, I was going to let you do it, but that's fine. Again, whoever wants it can have it. If they don't want it, don't worry about it because that can stand by itself. Like I said, it's just going to give a little bit of kick. So, guys, there's the plates. Again, they look beautiful. You guys did a great job. And again, serve it over some rice. I don't know how well it would stand by itself. Cook it as long as you want until it's as thick as you want, and then things are awesome. So a little bit of coriander, a little bit of sriracha sauce, and you're good to go. So I'm going to go ahead and take it off and turn you around. Now I can't see myself because I changed things tonight. So, but hey, look forward to Thursday. Gumbo's going to be a fun time. Again, Saturday we'll take care of that, and then I'll post it on Thursday. If you guys have any questions while you're watching it, though, go ahead and post those in the comments, and I'll look at those and make sure that I answer those for you guys. So, again, I appreciate you guys coming, and I'll look for you next time. Take care.